Since retiring 11 years ago, Wexford maths teacher Brigid McBride has invented a unique mathematical instrument.
Here I am today, not a young entrepreneur, but an entrepreneur nevertheless. I've come to the Den because I need the expertise and help, as well as the investment from the dragons. I'm confident in the product. What happens is in the lap of the gods.
As well as looking for investment, she's hoping to teach the dragons a lesson or two.
Hello, dragons. My name is Brigid McBride, and my company is called polyMath Limited. I'm a retired maths and science teacher, and I've invented, well, by accident, really, this little mathematical instrument, which I've called the polyMath. With the polyMath and one or two pencils, you can do all the constructions on the Junior Cert and Leaving Cert math syllabus. The polyMath is patent pending, the design is registered, and I have used €30,000 of my own money in it so far. I'm asking for €30,000 investment for 10% equity, and I would use that for marketing. Now, if you would like to try the polymaths out for yourselves, I will give you out some clipboards and pencils. We'll pretend we're making a pie chart. And now let's say I want to make an angle here of, we'll just say, 30 degrees.
Teacher, there's some bold pupils here misbehaving to my left here.
Will we consider detention maybe for the next infringement?
No,
infringement.
I'd say Eleanor got a lot of detention in her day.
Right. All right. Pay good attention now for the angle, right?
Right.
And there's your 30 degree angle there. Now, so any questions now, if you would like. I look first at your work, though, to see.
As Brigid decides who is her star pupil, the dragons must decide if they will invest in polyMath, her state exam approved, all-in-one geometry maths instrument.
My first gold star ever.
Oh, I did mine last grade. Do I get an extra 10%?
Oh, well, maybe you could get the extra star.
Oh, okay.
For Irish.
Margaret Boulter.
Right? And now, if there are any questions you'd like to ask, I'll do my best to answer them anyway.
Gurmila Mahgat os na realty galair.
Tha fault your oath. Tha fault your oath.
My dad was a teacher.
All right.
And I always had an incentive to try and get one up on the teacher for that reason, you know. So I was trying to figure out something that I couldn't do, you know.
Yes.
And I was thinking, could you bisect a line segment?
Oh, you could,
and
yeah.
You can. You've got your compass there.
Dollars.
And then I thought I had something which was construct an isosceles triangle, but make it 7.6 millimetres or something like that.
Oh, you could, yeah.
So I give up. That's why you're the teacher. And I'm sitting here. Go on, some of the pupils in the past class. Now they have more questions.
Well, any questions, I'll do my best to answer them.
It is very clever, and it's simple.
It's very simple, yeah.
What is the retail point of this product?
£350.
And you said earlier that you have a patent pending.
You're never sure you get a patent, but it's pending. But I have the design registered.
Where do you think it's going to sell?
There's a class set that comes in like a box like this. That's a class set. So schools buy that and individuals buy the individual items. I mean, I got terrific enthusiasm. Like, say, at the ploughing match, there were young people there, and I was collecting all these words that I wouldn't really use for appreciating something. It was cool a lot of the time, and it was awesome. It was class then. Then it was fair class, and it was radical. It was the one I'd really never heard before.
Where are you getting it produced?
Waterford, manufactured in Waterford.
And how much is it costing you?
Just now for the thing itself, without the packaging, is 30 cents.
And how many did you manufacture initially?
You had to manufacture really 5,000 to get, you know, to get it that, at that price.
Do you think, Bridget, some of the manufacturers will be a bit scared of this because, you know, the little cases that they sell with all of the things
pain.
And instead of having five things in it, now they've only one.
Oh, I thought of that all right. Yeah, I did. But what could I do about that? I couldn't uninvent it, you know. I was, you know.
We get a lot of people coming into the Den with an idea and not much else, but you've got the product. That's amazing. I mean, the only thing you're missing, really, is the marketing. And I think just being here is great marketing. And a lot of people will go on to polymath.ie tonight, I'm sure, and take it. But seeing that most of the help you need is in marketing, I'm out.
Thank you very much, Barry. Thank you.
A little bit the same. You've done all the work. I mean, I would almost feel guilty taking a percentage of your company. and only for that reason, I'm out.
Thank you very much, Eamon.
I think you can go alone on this and keep it all for yourself. I really do. So for that reason, I'm out.
Okay. Thank you very, very much.
With only two dragons remaining, will Gavin or Eleanor back Bridget's unique polymath invention?
Bridget, reluctantly, I'm going to pass on it. I'm out.
Okay. Thank you, Gavin. Thank you.
Bridget, I never thought I'd be attracted to a maths product because I hated maths. But I have to say, I agree with the rest of the guys. You've done most of this already. All you need is a bit of exposure. I wish you the very best, and I really think it's going to work for you. But
thank
for that reason,
much.
I'm out, Bridget. Thank you.
Thank you all very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
She was great, wasn't she?
Yeah.
I love the expression, I couldn't uninvent it. I thought that was superb.
Quite a good class, really. Pretty well behaved.